Hi guys, Rebecca here. I want to talk about a little bit about my personal story over the last, I guess it's been kind of these last several years. Give you a little insight on my own personal struggles with weight and fat loss. And I've always been short. I really didn't grow, I don't think, past eighth grade. So if you're shorty like me, you know that it is hard to keep that weight off. When you're short, when you gain weight, there's only so many places for it to go. I've never had a naturally fast metabolism. I've always had to work to keep my weight under control. I've kind of had, you know, ups and downs over the years. You know, when I was younger, I had a period where, you know, you're going through that teenage angst. I got real skinny. It wasn't really healthy for my body. Even though I'm only 5 foot, getting, you know, in the 90s, you know, early 100s, I still look gaunt because I have a wider bone structure, so it just doesn't look good. My body doesn't want to stay there anyways. But then I kind of gradually went through a phase where, you know, when I was running and active and I felt great, and I've always been a really avid runner. I've always loved running. It was always my go-to. My dad and I used to run half marathons. Of course, when we were younger, half marathons weren't... my nutrition wasn't where it is now. I think our carb loading from before races was maybe like onion rings and something like that. So I still had a long way to learn as far as nutrition and my health habits went. Obviously, once I became a nurse, all of those habits kind of fell in line. I was always able to kind of control my weight. Even there's periods when I can show you on my timeline where I was at my heaviest. For me, when I was, I think the heaviest I was for being 5 foot was like 130. But before I was ever lifting weights, I looked like a completely different person because there's no like muscle tone, no muscle composition in there at all. So I'll have to compose my two like pictures from like before I was, you know, 130, and then now I probably weigh about 130 right now. So it looks, I look like two completely different people. And it's all thanks to resistance training, burst training, you know, mixing things up, healthy eating, learning healthy lifestyle changes. And it's a gradual process, and it's kind of an evolution of yourself. So it will take time, so don't give up. If you're just starting to learn and educate yourself about, you know, what does healthy mean, how to incorporate that into your lifestyle. Anyways, so I was able to get over that hump when I was at post-college weight gain. I got my weight under control again. I then was probably the fittest I had ever been after I met my husband, and I really started getting into not just resistance training. I was starting getting into actually like lifting and, you know, really picking up some weight, and it felt really good, and I was actually running less, which is crazy for my mind to wrap around because, you know, running I thought was really all I needed, so it was crazy for me to actually pull back on that cardio aspect and lift more and get stronger, and then, oh my gosh, all of a sudden I had this six pack that I'd never had before, and I wasn't depriving myself. I was, you know, I was eating a lot more than I ever had when I was just trying to run and, you know, picket things, so I felt really good. Then about when I was probably at my peak, I think in nursing school, I suffered an injury, and sometimes I wonder, had I been stronger in my hips, maybe I would have been able to catch myself, or it's just one of those freak accidents that I was running, a squirrel or something ran across. This was downtown Louisville in nursing school, and I, to avoid, when I went flying on this curb, not curb, I guess it's a sidewalk. You know how the roots will push up the sidewalk? Well, that's what I fell on, essentially. So I turned real quick to land on my hips. I was trying to avoid my knees. That was the beginning of an injury that I had no idea what I had gotten myself into. By the time I went to the doctor, they said it was bursitis, and I didn't make the connection. Well, I did just fall on my hip a few months ago, so didn't think about it. Fast forward several years later, I'm getting ready. My husband's getting ready. You know, I think we're a few months before we got engaged. I started getting, and I was night shift nursing in the neonatal ICU. So long, long nights, and I was getting severe hip pain, like deep in there, like knock me out somebody, because it was radiating down the side of my leg. I mean, it was like nothing I've ever felt before, to be quite honest. I had a lot of muscle to fall back onto. I was still able to do PT at this point. And then I think that was maybe in like October kind of time frame. By January, in between there, I was still able to do burst training. So I was able to do those quick spurts of Tabata style workouts, and I actually was able to drop some more body fat that way because I was changing things up. So I was really surprised with that, which was good. You know, I'm thinking the wedding's coming up, so that's great, right? But then the pain got so severe, I couldn't walk from here to across the room. The doctors kind of brushed me aside, I think because I was 29 at the time, and she's young, what's wrong with her? So then I wasn't able to move at all. And then, because they weren't giving me any medicine, I wasn't even given any like anti-inflammatories and or really anything to kind of help me out. So I was still carrying ice pack around in the NICU, just trying to chart in between ice myself in between the babies. And it was really miserable. When my friend's husband's an urgent care doctor, I went and saw him. He gave me some prednisone just to kind of cool things off until that was meant, so until the doctors could figure out what was really wrong with me. Now, prednisone is just what every, you know, bride wants to be put on, right? So that really sucked. Anyway, so I was lucky I had muscle to fall back on. My metabolism at this point was still pretty strong. Well, then what happened was they read the MRIs wrong, so I'm thinking, I think they wanted to tell me I was crazy. But when they did that shot, they had put, I think, cortisone and some other things in there when I had this MRI that they looked deep into my hip. So that got me through about 3 months, got me through the wedding, thank God. I'm very blessed that I was able to walk down the aisle because it was a really struggle for me. I wasn't able to work out. I was just praying to God that it won't come back. Whatever this was, maybe it's done with, maybe it won't come back. About 3 months later, we started to, we got married, it was wonderful. I had a pediatric day facility job. We had made this big decision, like, we've always wanted to do this. I've always wanted to get my nutritional coaching and actually put it into practice and, you know, utilize my certifications and just go for it. So by the time we started decided to open the business, that pain came back. And this time I had walked, it was worse. I could hear like things cracking and crunching in my hip, and it would lock and freeze up. And I mean, I could come from here to across the room and go to the kitchen just to make some dinner. And because your body's out of alignment, my back would hurt so bad. So I had two major things hurting now because of just being my body so jacked up for so long. So I had a big loss in muscle over this time because you'd think like it's been a whole year now of not being able to really do anything. And so then we went to other doctors. No, I can't explain to you. If anybody has ever tried to get a diagnosis that and kept coming up with wrong diagnoses or just no answers, I feel for you because I've experienced that and it is the worst thing in the world. I would lay around here thinking, oh my gosh, I have bone cancer. We went to see another doctor. So what do? They kept putting me on prednisone at this point. Kind of like, well, it worked in the past, where we'll just keep giving her this just to shut her up. I mean, that's how I felt. So then I'm on prednisone. Then my face is, you know, you get the poofy face and you get blown up and you just feel like absolute crap. You're like roid rage crazy because you're craving sugar, you're angry, your emotions are all crazy because of this drug. I mean, I felt horrible. My body was changing rapidly and there wasn't anything I could do. And so that was a really hard time for me because I'm thinking, we're opening this fitness facility. Oh my gosh. I'm supposed to be, you know, in charge of these women and help them lose weight when I can't even do anything for myself. You know, my hormones were all out of whack. I was trying to start eating healthy, trying to get, you know, back on track, figure out where I was derailing myself. But it was really, really a struggle. It was kind of a really dark time for me. I was really just kind of depressed. You know how it is, like when your body changes and all of a sudden you can't fit into your jeans. I couldn't even get one thigh in my jean, and so it was really just awful. Because I'm thinking, I have all these clothes, I can't wear anything. I barely have any workout clothes anymore because I can't fit into anything. I can't even work out. I'm in constant pain. I'm supposed to be helping these women out, and I can't even bring the energy that I feel like I need to bring to really motivate them. So it was a really hard time. I did end up getting referred to by my wonderful physical therapist referred me to a doctor that actually listened to me. We ended up going to Nashville. I ended up getting surgery. I had a ruptured ligament that connects to ball socket to the pelvis. It's called, I might pronounce this wrong, ligamentum teres. And I had a large labral tear in there from that impact of that fall. Most people, I think, they said that have an injury, get it from a fall or car accident. So I really just slammed it, hit it, and so It just shows you too that that rupture didn't show up on the MRI. So if someone's telling you something's wrong with your body and you know that something's, you know, or something's really, there's really wrong and they're telling you you're fine, get other opinions because it's so worth it. So I had the surgery, and so my big comeback was, you know, I was on crutches for 6 weeks. It was really hard trying to struggle with nutrition, and then I started to get to the point where, like, I'm not losing weight fast enough. Maybe I need to go low carb. Maybe I need to do something. I don't understand what's wrong, you know. So I had all those natural things too going against everything that I know, and you know, and I'm certified in the nutrition, and I know what I'm talking about. So, you know, even when you gain weight, you still have those doubts. Like, maybe I just need to find something that's going to work for me. What's going on? So I had all of those experiences, and you can't look at the scale. You have to go by your inches, how your clothes are fitting. Body composition is something completely different. I can eat a big meal, step on the scale, and weigh 4 pounds heavier. I can tell you, then 4 hours later, it'll go down. You know, food has nothing to do. There's different factors that go into that scale. So go by your measurements. Go by the way your clothes fit. I gradually kept on this track. It's been about a little over a year now, and I'm finally able to fit into my jeans again. So I'm very, very proud of that. I have not decreased my calories. I have not, you know, counted calories. I've ate well-balanced meals. Anytime I've ever tried to do low-carb, my body type resists it. I feel like crap. I just can't do it. But I will say it's about learning the right portions. You have to get to this mode of, it's not, I can't have this, I can't have that. It's more of learning, like I said, this balance of control, of knowing what's right for your body and what you need to be eating. I don't go Monday through Friday and eat perfect, and then all of a sudden Saturday I'm, you know, having my cheat meal. I probably have at least, you know, I don't know how many times a day you're eating. You know, I probably have at least 4 times a week where I'm eating things that I probably shouldn't be doing, and that's not perfect every week. You're going to have weeks where you're not perfect, but the point of kind of sharing my story with you is I want to share that, like, you can be consistent and you can see results. Weight loss takes time and it's frustrating, especially when it's a hormonal thing. Your body has to kind of get back into balance, and it takes time. And I know that you're frustrated, and I know, especially if you have a lot of weight to lose, but just keep your head up. Be consistent. Eat as clean as you can. Eat healthy. Cut out the processed foods. Don't worry about indulging here and there. It's not going to derail your diet, because if you're eating healthy, making good choices throughout the week, the 4 times or whatever you have some chocolate or a beer, it's not going to derail your diet. It's those everyday choices, not the sometimes foods. Anyways, if you have a similar experience, I'd love to hear your story. So make sure you comment below, like our page, leave any comments, make sure you subscribe to our channel, and I will be talking to you soon.